daughters. So these are bloody 5 things I hate about my daughter. Okay. First thing, when we go to bloody McDonald's, she never decides what to order. She's like, oh, mommy, I want to go to the McDonald's. I get the McChicken and the Burger King. So I say, okay. I'm nice, mommy. I give her treat. I give her the McDonald's, the Burger King. I give her the White Castle, even though she fights and messes up my car. So, let me tell you this one time. I am working. I'm paying phone bill. She don't pay no bloody bills. She still is living here. I mean, I understand she's in the 5th grade, but still. Oh my God, my shim. Okay. Yeah. So, I'm bloody paying bills, and she's like, mommy, can we go to Burger King? Can we go to the White Castle, the McDonald's? So I'm like, okay, fine. Just brush my hair. Okay. I said, fine. Stop paying bills, get into the car, drive to the White Castle. So I'm like, what you want? They have to hurry up and hurry up. And on order, there are people behind us. And I said, long line, people are honking at me. And she's just like, And I start yelling at her. I'm like, you bloody stupid, man. Didn't you decide what you wanted to order? How are you gonna do this to me? To me? So she's like, okay, why are you always yelling at me? Oh my God, you're not fair. Let's just go home. Oh my God. So I take her home, finish paying phone bill. And guess what? I said, okay, how about making some oxtail, some protein? She says, no, I'm not hungry. What? No, I'm not hungry. You bloody show me, get to your room! 2 minutes later, she comes down to eat a bloody my yogurt. I put my name on that. It says Nicole on that yogurt. She eat my yogurt. Number 2, she's so bloody rude. She never says thank you. I swear, it was Christmas. Here's another story. It was bloody Christmas. So like all aunties and grandpas come over. Grandpa gave her iPhone 6, iPhone 7, whatever you call it. My ears is too friendly for me. And you know what she does? She's like, I'm like, see, thank you. She's like, I said thank you. I said, Pa, Daddy, did she say thank you? He's like, no. And he starts yelling at me, like, this is how you raise your children? I did not raise you like this. You won't say thank you each time of crap. You won't say thank you each time you get something nice and present. And I got to yell that. Throughout our Christmas, Dad yelled at me over the phone. Not a short story, but whatever. Number 3, she always eating my yogurt. This morning, last night, I bought a yogurt Activia for me because I got the bloody heart problems. So I put my name on the post-it on it and I put it in the fridge. I wake up this morning to put like a mashed up from granola bars to put it in my yogurt. And you know what? Open it up. My yogurt's gone. They're gonna trash. I don't see a yogurt container. Okay. I'll decide to let it slide for this time because I'm a good mommy. So I walk into a living room, the vacuum living room. Look at it, Friday. Bloody yogurt spilled all over my carpet. My new carpet. She spilled my bloody carpet. I call down my husband, Manjeet. Just kidding, his name is Don. Don! Yes. What is this? Did you spill my bloody yogurt? No, I didn't eat yogurt. I'm the lactose intolerant. You ate bloody chocolate 2 days ago. And cheese. He's like, no, I didn't spill it. So I called down my daughter, Klein. I'm like, Klein, get down here. She She's like, yeah, mom. I'm like, yeah, mom, that's not how you're supposed to answer me. She's like, yes, mom. I'm like, you didn't have to say it to Nadu, but whatever. She's not 13. I'm like, give a little smack. I'm like, did you bloody spill my yogurt? You spilled my bloody yogurt? Mom, I don't have any yogurt. I don't want my yogurt. I already ate my yogurt and now 2 nights ago. So I'm like, okay. She's like, wait a second. Alex ate it. You're bloody lying. I saw you go, you looked over there, go to your room, you grabbed it, you bloody stupid. My mom. Number four. I see the Christmas thing. The burger castle. That thing. So I'm on number four. I caught my eyes. Gonna sleep. She always never home. She's never home. She's always like, oh mom, I'm going to party, going to my friend's house. I'm like, okay. Last night at 1 o'clock, I'm cleaning up dishes. No one to clean the dishes. My husband's sitting in the bloody room, just watching the TV. All my other children, they're in the bedroom on the iPods. And I'm bloody cleaning. And I hear the door open. I'm like, who there? And I see her walking, her little legs walking like, do, 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 do. I'm like, no. I'm like, where are you? She's like, at my friend's house. We come back at 12 o'clock at midnight. Bloody stupid. You grab it for the next 2 weeks. And I got a parent teacher call conference that is scheduled for 3 weeks. Well, I got to do something in 3 weeks. And you bloody stupid. I'm like, go. I'm just going to be 10 minutes of this video of me complaining. Not complaining, I'm telling you all the things that's wrong with my daughter. I'm bringing my brush. Bloody beautiful. Moving on. My final thing. The thing I hate most. The number one. She looks like a dang reptile. Don't put on no lotion, no moisture in her skin. She don't take care of her. Lotion, I swear, she would wear the booty shorts. I let her go out like that. I said, I'm a good mom. They're like, no, put on short pants. Okay, she has on her booty shorts. I'm like, what is wrong with your ankle? She's like, nothing. Boy! No. Don't make me smack you like you have no life. Like, I will smack you harder than I have ever even touched you. Think this is. Obviously, she doesn't know what this is. I'm like, okay. You bloody stupid! Okay, give me a second. I'm like, okay. I will beat your freaking hand product. One second. Share picking things. And then she has the audacity to curse it to me. You know what I'm saying? Go. Yeah, I'm like, what's wrong with your ankle? She's like, nothing. You're gonna get bloody eczema. The bloody cancer. She's like, mom, you're gonna get cancer from not putting on lotion. I'm like, well, you stupid. That's why. Okay? So do you know what she says? She says, "No, I'm just done with you. I tell her, I'm done with you. I'm done with you, doctor. I had enough. Go to your room. You're not going out for the rest of that week. And I just can't handle you right now." So she says, "Son of a..."